way of shortening the BTO waiting time of three to four years? Because that's what.
Yes, there is. There is. The best way of doing that is to plan ahead during the fiancé scheme. So if you can actually register to buy today for a BTO flat, you know, and then after you get married, say 1 year or 2 years down the road. The flat would have been, you know, you only need to wait, say, 1 or 2 years after your marriage. So that's one way of shortening the time. You can't shorten it further because that's a minimum time for you to really build a flat. It's no different from if you were to buy a private flat and you go and book any of the new flats in town today, the private condos. It's the same amount of time that you need to wait. So really, there's no difference. What we cannot do, obviously, is to have large stock of flats readily available. You know, large stock, let's say in a supermarket, and then somebody gets married, and then after he gets married, he comes along, and then he goes and chooses flats. I think we can't do that. That would require us to really build up a huge stock of flats, which with no assurance of anybody buying it, no assurance of take-up rate. And I think that would simply mean that there will be a lot of flats lying empty, which is what we experienced in the early 2000 period. And that created a lot of anxiety. The irony, as always, is that if there's a lot of flats, prices are low, people don't want to buy. Right? And I had 25,000 flats on my hands, HDB. 25,000 all over Singapore. Very low prices in the early 2000 period. And people just didn't want to buy. You know, you could walk in and buy it, but nobody wanted to buy because prices were low. And then when prices are high, when prices are going up, everybody wants to buy because they're worried that you go up even higher. It's strange psychology, but I think that's how all markets tend to work.